I am so glad that you are watching it. You're tuning in to Children's Ministry. Good morning, good afternoon, whatever time that you are tuning in to Children's Ministry. I want you to know that I'm glad that you're here, glad that you're listening, staying connected to Children's Ministry. I miss all of you, those who I'm not seeing inside of church. I miss everyone. I love you. So we're going to get into the word on today, what God has for us. Get your Bibles, get your phones, your tablets, whatever you have the word of God on. And we're going to get into our word for this week, Faith Kids. I know you've been blessed how God is speaking to you in his words, where we've been studying in the book of James. We've been studying about persevering and don't quit. We've been talking about being wise, getting godly wisdom. And then we talked about on last week how we ought to be submissive. We're being humble before the Lord. And today we got another word from God, what he has for us to do. So we're going to begin with the word of prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, we come just to thank you always for who you are in our lives. We thank you, God, that we, Father, submit ourselves unto you, God. We thank you for your word, that your word is powerful, that it will not go out, and it will not go out and return unto you void, but it will accomplish those things which you have sent it to do. We thank you as we gather around your word of today, that your Holy Spirit lead, God, and direct us in what we're doing, God. Lead, God, and directing us, God, in revelation of truth in your word on today. And we will give you, God, all the praise, honor, and glory for everything that shall be said, for everything that shall be accomplished. In your Son, Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. So, Faith Kids, let's get into the Bible. Of course, we're still going to be studying in the book of James, but let's go over first to Psalms chapter 29. You know, find it, those books of the Bible. We're over in the Old Testament, the book of Psalms, and we're going to go to chapter 29, and we're going to read stanza number 2. As you're turning there, I will read. It says, give unto the Lord. I am reading from the New King James Version. Give unto the Lord the glory, do his name, worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Are you there, Faith Kids, reading that scripture along with me? It says, we are to do what? Give unto the Lord the glory that is due him. We are to worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. In the Living Translation says, honor the Lord for the glory of his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. It tells us, Faith Kids, that we are to what? Give God glory. And that is the topic of our message on today, is that we are to give glory to God. Give glory to God. The scripture tells us here that we're to give God the glory. So as we go over to the book of James, and since we've been studying on James, and we want to see what is he saying on this about giving God the glory. We talked about it some on last week when we were talking about, you know, being submissive to God and humbling ourselves before him. So if you go over to the New Testament, and let's go to the book of James, we're in chapter number 4, and we're going to read verse number 13. So go over to New Testament, James, chapter 4, and we're going to start with verse number 13. So we're talking about give glory to God. Give glory to God. And while you're turning there to James, let me ask you a question, Faith Kids. When you go to like concerts or, you know, performances, or, you know, someone is, you know, you're going to see someone on stage and they're performing, whether, you know, even maybe it's a game or something, or maybe it's a speech, or maybe they're singing a song at a performance, or maybe they're acting out a play, or whatever it is. What do we do when we're supporting them and they're up on the stage or they're on the field? We're cheering them on, right? We begin to do what? That's right. We begin. I know you said it. We begin to applaud them. We begin to clap for them and show them that, you know, they're doing good and that we appreciate them and what they're saying is good or what they're doing was good. So if we do that to our friends, to our families, to sports people, whomever, to singers, and we're applauding them and we're clapping them, How much more are we supposed to give God glory? We're supposed to give him glory for all that he's doing in our lives, for everything that we do, because we know that it's not us that we're doing it. We're not doing things on our own, faith kids. It's because the God who is in us is working in us, through us, and for us. And that's why we give him the glory. So are you there? In James chapter 4, let's begin reading in verse number 13. It reads, "Look here, you who say, today or tomorrow, we are going to a certain town and we will stay there a year. We will do business there and make a profit." So here, the people that James is talking about, they're making plans to do things. They say, we're going to go over here. We're going to do this. We're going to, you know, stay here a year and make some money. You know how we plan things that we think what we want to do? Are they wrong for planning? Let's find out. Let's continue to talk and see what's going on. So in the next verse, it says, "How do you know what your life will be like tomorrow? Your life is like the morning fog. It's here a little while and then it is gone." So James is saying in the scriptures, how are you planning? He's talking to the people. He says, how are you planning that what you're going to do in a year from there, and you doing all of this planning? He says, don't you know that your life is just like when you see the fog in the morning? Have you woken up and it's been a foggy morning? Then all of a sudden, you know, you look back out there, look outside, and the fog is clear. It's like gone. That is how he's referencing our life, is that our life here on this earth is like fog. We see it and then it's gone. Because what? Compared to eternity with God, compared to eternity, our life here on the earth, 120 years, is short. That's what he's saying. You know, it's like the fog is here and it's gone. Because even 120 years to us seems like a long time, but not compared to being in eternity with the Lord. So compared to being in eternity, our time here on the earth is very short. So he's saying, you're making all these plans and you're doing all these things, and you have not recognized God, that you do things in God. It wasn't that they can't plan. It wasn't that you're not supposed to say, okay, what is it? No, it is. You're supposed to be finding out what God has for you. Let's continue to read. It says, what you ought to say, if the Lord wants us, we will live and do this and do that. That's what we're supposed to do. We're not supposed to say, I'm gonna do this and I'm gonna do that and I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna go there and I'm gonna have this job and I'm gonna have this car and I'm gonna have this house and I'm gonna do this and I'm gonna do that. Not recognizing God, because we cannot do things of our own self, fakers. So we have to always give God glory for everything, for where we are, for the grades you make, for the things that you do at school. You give God the glory. He is the one who's with you. Because remember, the scripture tells us, I can do all things what? Through Christ who strengthens me. So it is Jesus who's in us, who's strengthening us, that we're able to do things. So in whatever we do, we always want to give God the glory. We don't want to be bragging and boasting that I did this and I did that. No, we say, it is God in us who has enabled me to make good grades, who has enabled me to pass this test, or who has enabled me to be above in my class, who has enabled me to receive scholarships, who has enabled me to be the greatest on the team. It is him. We want to always give God glory. Have you seen the people on TV, the sports people, when they're interviewing them, they say, you know, I'm going to thank my mom. And that's good. They can thank their mom, but they also need to thank who has given them that ability, and it is God. So that's what he is telling us here in the scriptures, that whatever we're doing, that we want to give him glory, knowing that it's not in us, it is not us that we can do it all, because we can't, but it's because of him who lives in us that we're able to do things, that we're able. Remember, we talked about being wise, having wisdom, that is him, it's his wisdom, godly wisdom, that enable us to know things. When people ask you, how do you know? Because the wisdom of God. And we want to always give God his glory. Whatever that we're doing, we want to give God the glory. Let's keep reading In verse number 16, it says, otherwise, you are boasting about your own plans, and all such boasting is evil. Again, if we're saying it's me who did this, and you know, and it's good that we can applaud others. We can tell them how good they're doing, their, you know, whatever their achievement in you is good. But also, but we have to know that it's God. We're not bragging in ourselves, but it is God who enable us to do these things, who enable us. Because he says, look, we're living the abundant life. So we're ahead. We're the lender. We're the, not the borrower. We're the head, not the tail. So what all that we do is always because God is in our lives, working through us, enabling us to be who he has called us to be. He enabling us to be on top. That's what he wants for us. He wants you on top. He wants you to be the best that you can. He wants you to succeed in everything because he tells us we meditate upon his word and whatever we put our hands to do will be successful. But it's successful what? With him. So we want to always faith kids. When all that you do, whatever you're doing and exceeding in life and your day by day, you give God the glory that it is from him that he allows you, that he's enabling you, that he's strengthening you to do what you are doing. So we don't want to be boasting and bragging in our own abilities, in our own selves, thinking that, you know, I did this. No, we did it because of who is helping us, that God is with us. He said he never leaves us, so he's always with us. It's him who is enabling us to do these. And so when we were talking about submitting and being humble, that's what he says. Remember, we talked about submit last week on submit unto God and resist the devil and he will flee and God will reward you. So when we're submitting to him and being humbling before him, he enabling us to do what it is that we need to do, whether it's passing the test, whether it's being the greatest on a team, whether it's playing an instrument, whether whatever it is that you're doing, faith kids, always know that God is with you. He's strengthening you. He's enabling you, empowering you to do whatever that you need to do. And we want to always do what? Give God glory. We never want to take the glory from him. We want to always give God the glory. All right, faith kids, I know you've had a great time in the word on today. Don't forget your memory verse in Psalms 29, stanza number 2. It says that we are to do what, faith kids? Give God the glory that is due him. So I will see you on next week, faith kids. Thank you. Bye.